This month's Japanese history focuses on the Meiji Restoration, as we did last time. The Meiji Restoration was a movement to defeat the Tokugawa shogunate and reform the modernization of Japan, which took place at the end of the Edo period. In the previous article, I have explained how Yoshinobu Tokugawa handed over power to the imperial court. In this article, I will explain the events leading up to the Boshin War from the return of power to the imperial court. Even though he had handed over power to the imperial court, Yoshinobu Tokugawa still intended to run the government under his own leadership, uniting the shogunate, the imperial court, and the powerful feudal lords. Yoshinobu, who had been in Kyoto, moved to Osaka to conduct his affairs there. It is said that this was done in order to control Osaka, which was a key transportation point in case of war. Tomomi Iwakura lobbied the Emperor Meiji and asked him to issue a major decree for the restoration of the monarchy. This proclaimed the abolition of the Edo shogunate and the establishment of a new government. However, Yoshinobu condemned this restoration of the monarchy and declared to the ministers of various countries that he, not the emperor, had the authority to conduct diplomacy. It was also informally decided that Yoshinobu would be the chairman of the council of influential people who would run the government. In response to this situation, Saigo of Satsuma plotted to destroy the Yoshinobu faction by force. Although Yoshinobu relinquished power, his retainers and the samurai of the shogunate were not convinced of this. By provoking them, Saigo was trying to trigger a war. He used a ronin in Edo to attack the city. They broke into the homes of large merchants in Edo, robbed and murdered them. They always fled to the Satsuma domain residence, and the citizens of Edo called this group of ronin the Satsuma certified thieves. The shogunate had ordered the Shonai clan to guard Edo, but fearing trouble with Satsuma, they tried not to provoke the ronin. As a result, the ronin became even more insatiable and rampaged through Edo. The shogunate could not stand this and formed the shogunate army to attack the Satsuma domain residence. Yoshinobu, who was in Osaka, interpreted this as the shogunate and Satsuma entering into a state of war. The Aizu clan and Kuno clan, who were in Osaka, were outraged by this and made their hostility to Satsuma clear. A large number of samurai begged Yoshinobu to give the order to avenge Satsuma. Yoshinobu said, "Is there anyone in the shogunate who is as good as Takamori, Saigo, and Toshimiki Okubo? Even if we fought Satsuma now, there was no guarantee that we would win. In the worst case, the imperial court would call us enemies. The shogunate should never challenge Satsuma to a battle." However, Yoshinobu was unable to stop these samurai and informed the imperial court of his intention to defeat Satsuma and marched to Kyoto. On January 2, 1868, the shogunate forces marched into Kyoto with 15,000 troops. At Toba and Fushimi, the entrances to Kyoto, the Satsuma army blocked the road. Yoshinobu had told them to refrain from military action until they entered Kyoto, and many of the samurai in the shogunate army had been told that they would accompany Yoshinobu on his journey to Kyoto, and many of them were lightly armed. The Satsuma army, which was blocking the road at Toba, suddenly opened fire on the shogunate troops, who had a different fighting spirit, and the shogunate forces fell into chaos. Hearing the gunfire from Toba, the Satsuma forces in Fushimi also opened fire on the shogunate forces. Tomotake Tokugawa, the general of the shogunate army, heard the gunfire and fled, and the shogunate army, without a commander, was crushed. In Fushimi, the Aizu clan, the main force of the shogunate army, and the Shinsengumi fought against the Satsuma army. At this time, the Satsuma army had 5,000 men and the shogunate army had 15,000, but they were unable to make good use of this difference in strength. While the attacking shogunate troops tried to break through the narrow streets, the defending Satsuma troops shot them accurately, and the shogunate troops only suffered more casualties. On January 3, an urgent meeting was held at the imperial court in Kyoto. Toshimiki Okubo said that if the shogunate forces entered Kyoto, the new government would collapse and the emperor would have to issue a decree to defeat the Tokugawa. Sengoku Matsudaira said that this was a private battle between Aizu and Satsuma and that the imperial court should be neutral. In the end, Tomomi Iwakura agreed to the decree to conquer the Tokugawa, and the decree to conquer the Tokugawa was decided. Toyotosa's Yodo Yamauchi said that the war was a private battle between Satsuma and Aizu and that Tosa samurai were strictly forbidden to join the battle. However, based on a secret agreement between Tosa and Satsuma, many Tosa soldiers joined the battle and opened fire on the shogunate forces. On January 4, the imperial court recognized the Satsuma and Choshu armies as the official army, with the emperor's relatives as the general commanders. Yoshinobu Tokugawa, who was in Osaka Castle, had no desire to fight from the start, and when he heard that fighting had begun in Toba and Fushimi, he shut himself up even more. When he heard that the Satsuma army was the government army and the shogunate army was a bandit army fighting against the imperial court, he was greatly surprised. He said, "I have no intention to stand against the imperial court. It's sad that he ended up bearing the stigma of being a bandit. If only we had persuaded the Aizu and Kuna clans to let us return to our hometowns, none of this would have happened." He was determined to be relevant to the imperial court, but he did not let his bloodthirsty neighbors know his true intentions. Yoshinobu made up his mind to leave Osaka Castle and return to Edo. In Osaka, he would have to fight against the Satsuma and Choshu armies, which had become the government's army as the general-in-chief. Yoshinobu escaped Osaka Castle with only a few people and headed for Edo, accompanied by Katamori Matsudaira, Lord of the Aizu Domain, and Sadaki Matsudaira, Lord of the Kuna Domain. Samurai from the Aizu and Kuna clans of the shogunate's army fighting in Kyoto were informed that their general, Yoshinobu Tokugawa, and their lords had fled to Edo. They lost their will to fight and were in a state of total collapse. The shogunate's army was as well equipped as the Satsuma and Choshu armies and outnumbered them, but with the general gone, there was no purpose to fight. At this point, the fate of the Edo shogunate came to an end. That's it for this commentary. Next time I'll explain about the bloodless siege of Edo Castle. If you find it interesting, please subscribe to the channel and click